ordering the correct LED strip from the many variants that are available can make you feel like you're drowning in the stuff. After all, installing LED strip can elevate a space from mundane to outstanding, but selecting the wrong one can lead to complete disaster. So we're going to explain all the differences to help you make the correct decision and make sure there's no nasty surprises when you open the box.
In the previous video in this series, we took LED strip apart and looked at how it was structured. We said that the LED mounted on the front here was referred to as an SMD or surface mounted device, but there is an entirely different type of LED strip that's referred to as COB, which stands for chip on board.
Just a quick heads up, if you're watching this video on any of our social media accounts, click the link in the description to view it as part of our free training package to help you with your CPD, and you'll receive a certificate. If you're already watching it as part of that training package, then thanks for your patience. Either way, back to COB.
If we lay a COB strip next to the SMD type, the difference in looks is really obvious. The SMD type has the individual LED modules installed at discrete distances. The COB has this long, thin strip running down the centre. This is because what we think of as an LED is actually made up of several smaller components. Each SMD LED has a small rectangular frame like a tray. This is referred to as the package, and it has the tiny LED chip fixed to it. And the yellow coloured part surrounding it is actually a phosphorescent material that glows when the blue light from the LED chip passes through it, and actually contributes more to the colour temperature of the chip than the light emitting part. This whole package is then soldered on the printed circuit board, or PCB, that feeds the LEDs and the other components on here. The COB strip is a little different. You can think of it as being like one LED unit, but stretched out along the entire length of the LED strip. Instead of one LED chip in individual packages like the SMD, the LED chips are mounted directly to the PCB along the back of the strip. Then the whole length of the strip is covered in a curved phosphorescent moulding. That phosphor is the same stuff you'll find in a fluorescent tube. So why the two different types, and which should you use? Well, when you're installing LED strip, it's either going to be visible, mounted on the surface of something, or it's going to be hidden away from view. If the strip is hidden away inside a recess or along the underside of an object, then you may be better off installing the SMD type. This is because the light that's emitted from the individual LED packages will blend together and get reflected off the surrounding surfaces, so that it gives the effect of a single homogeneous source of light. However, if this type of strip was installed somewhere it was on view, then the individual points of light could be seen and would be a little intense to the human eye, which doesn't look great. This effect can be improved if the LED tape is installed inside an extrusion with a translucent cover. The cover acts as a diffuser and makes the individual dots of light blend into the effect of a single source. If the strip is going to be on show, proudly displayed as the light source, then COB will give a better result, as the phosphorescent encapsulation gives a built-in single source of light effect.
What other decisions will you have to make on the journey to the correct strip? A really important consideration is the colour of the light source. You could either go for a fixed colour, a tunable colour, or a changeable colour. What's the difference?
Well, a fixed colour usually means some different temperature of white. You'll find this referred to in specifications as CCT, which stands for Correlated Colour Temperature. The technical measurement for this is a value in Kelvin. So for example, this Vegas LED strip from Robus has a value of 3000 Kelvin, and this one has a value of 4000 Kelvin. You can clearly see the difference between the two, with the 3000 Kelvin giving off a warm white light and the 4000 Kelvin giving a cooler white. Robus also have a version of their strip called the Ambient, which has a colour temperature of 2200 Kelvin, which is a really warm white. In fact, you'll also see these terms being used to describe the light output from white LEDs, things like warm white, neutral white, and cool white. So which would you want to use? Well, it really depends on the application. If the space you're lighting is used for resting and relaxing, then a warm white light is better, as it can create a cozy, restful atmosphere. If, however, the space is more practical, like a kitchen being used to prepare a meal, then something cooler can help to create a dynamic, active vibe while providing good colour rendering too. But what if the space is used differently at different times? Again, maybe the kitchen is a kitchen diner, and you want the lighting to change from a cool white while you're cooking to a warm white when the food is served and it's time to relax and enjoy the meal. The answer then is to use a tunable LED strip. This type of strip allows you to change the colour temperature of the light output using either a simple remote control or even an app in some cases. So we can start out with this strip running at 2700 Kelvin and keep adjusting it until it hits the maximum level of cool white at 6500 Kelvin, which is designed to mimic natural daylight. Anything beyond this and it's starting to resemble a neutron star. which is probably a bit too intense for most people. Then we come to RGB strip. This type has LEDs that each give off a single colour, either red, green or blue, hence the initials. When you combine different levels of each of these light output colours, you can get a huge range of almost infinitely variable colours. This type of strip is really great where you want to create a really powerful effect. If your installation calls for just one of the colours to be used, it is actually possible to only connect up one of the individual colour connections out of the driver. This can then be controlled by a simple on-off switch to produce the single colour effect, saving on the cost of installation and improving the running costs. The next thing to consider is where the strip is going to be used. This is important because you'll need to select a strip with the correct IP rating. If you cast your mind back to the first video in the series, we saw that on the simplest LED strips you have these little pieces of exposed copper. They're there to act as connection points and they present no danger to a human due to the extra low voltage they run on. However, if moisture gets across the contacts that can start to cause damage to the strip and the driver, that's why this type of strip is rated at IP20, meaning it offers no protection to the ingress of moisture. In many situations, this is never going to be a problem. If the strip is installed indoors in a place where it's not likely to get moisture on it, then it'll be fine. If the strip is installed somewhere that it might get a bit wet from time to time, then it may be time to look at a strip that has a higher IP rating. For example, this LED strip from Robus comes in both IP20 and IP67 ratings. The 7 at the end of the code means that it is protected against immersion between 15 to 100 centimeters deep. Keep in mind though that the entire system needs to be rated at the same level if it's to be exposed to the same moisture levels. So for example, any connectors in the strip would need the same rating as well as the driver. If you're not sure you can achieve this, then the driver could be located elsewhere.
And speaking of drivers, if you're watching on our training platform, then answer the multiple choice questions that follow and move on to the next video. If you're watching on one of our social media channels, then click the link to move over to the free training package and get yourself a certificate, or you can watch the same video in the series right here to find out how we pick the right driver for your installation. All that remains is to say, thank you very much for watching.